Doctor?
Good morning.
We have been talking about how susceptible the unvaccinated are, but what are the demographics of the people who are getting really, really sick?
Well, it depends where you look. If you look in Cook County, it's the black people have a much higher rate of severe disease. They're also under vaccinated than whites, than Latinos, and then Asians. So it really just depends on the demographics where you look. But it all boils down to vaccination. Which groups are vaccinated, which groups are not. That's the real driver, not so much anything else.
And the percentage of the vaccinated versus unvaccinated getting very sick?
It's dramatic. You look in the hospitals, it's 80 to 90% unvaccinated people. You look in the ICUs, it's even higher. It's over 90% unvaccinated. And if you look at the overall death rate from COVID, for a fully vaccinated person, it's 0.024%. That is incredibly small risk, and it typically is in higher in people with underlying diseases.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions. This person says, when will the Omicron peak hit? Hospitalization numbers are down in some states and up in others.
Well, the United States is so big that it's happening all over the place. So your places like New York, Washington, D.C., Minnesota are going down and places like Oklahoma, Georgia, and Colorado are still going up. So the country as a whole hasn't peaked, but it's going to peak very soon, probably in the next 2 weeks, and then you're going to see it come down.
All right, next question. The head of Pfizer says he sees a return to normal life in spring with COVID drugs available. Do you agree?
Well, I hope it's true, but I don't know. Scott Gottlieb, the former FDA director, said the same thing last summer, around July 4th when the rates were low. So, he's a great guy, but it's really hard to predict this.
This person says, I tested positive for COVID on Wednesday. My husband tested negative on Wednesday and Friday. We did not quarantine from each other. We are both vaccinated and boosted. Did my husband have a better efficacy to the vaccine than I did?
Well, it's possible, but it could also be just exposure. Since the wife is vaccinated, she probably wasn't that contagious.
All right.
What are the risks if a vaccinated first trimester pregnant woman contracts breakthrough COVID?
Well, pretty much just like everybody else, very unlikely to get severe disease. So that will help the pregnancy.
All right. Have you heard any news of Medicare not reimbursing for at-home COVID tests? This person says, I guess that group doesn't count.
I heard that this morning. I really have a hard time getting my head around that, to believe that Medicare is not covered by this website or interact with this website and get these tests sent to you. Medicare doesn't count and uninsured don't count. If that's true, it's really one of the dumbest things of this pandemic.
Here's another question. After testing positive for COVID-19, schools are getting away from contacting close contacts. Is that because schools know everyone is a close contact or everyone is going to get it?
It's futile. There's so much COVID that they don't have the manpower to do it. So they put in just place overall policies.
All right. This person says, explain again why this isn't just like the flu. It is a common question among the unvaccinated in our Northwest suburban community.
Let's make this simple. It's more contagious than the flu, much more contagious, and it's more lethal than the flu. It is not the flu.
All right, Dr. Murphy, thanks for being with us again. If you did not get your question answered, you can the doctor answers them biweekly on Northwestern.